My name is Ben. I'm the FabLab manager of Genk. I'm talking about designing open self-management tools for diabetics in a FabLab today. You have to note the self-management tools, not self-care tools. We don't develop anything that has to do with the disease or helps to treat the disease. What's diabetes? It's a chronic high glucose, sugar glucose in the blood. So they have to monitor everything. They have a lot of devices with them. This is what I'm going to talk about, by the way. And they have a lot of tools with them that are medically engineered, but never from their perspective. So this is a team. We have four people that work on this project. We have two communications people that develop methods to get the people to design, and then me. But if we're no doctors, as I said, we don't make stuff that cures diabetes. It's not our intention. What we want to do is to make things that make their life more, how do you say that, more easy throughout the day. How do we do that? We try to involve people with diabetes in our fab lab. We try to get a bottom-up approach instead of a top-down, like, we're going to make this for you. We started with people in the fab lab and said, yeah, what is the problem? How can we solve it? What do you suggest to make? We noticed, I'm going to talk about it later, that they're not designers. Like they said, you can say personal fabrication. Yes, it's all good and well, but they don't know how to design. So we have to try and help them in the design process and say, yeah, you can do this and that with the machines. And then they can say, yeah, we have this experience, we're not going to use it every day. Like a simple battery can be too much. If they have to recharge it every day, they say, yeah, that product we're not going to use because we have to use it for the rest of our life. If you have to recharge it the rest of our lives, that's crazy. So what do we want to do? We want to make everything we make open source so everybody can make it in their own fab lab. So that's that difference from the traditional. Everybody can alter it and can redefine the product to suit their own life. A fab lab is ideal for this things because you can do rapid prototyping with 3D printers and you can use the laser cutter, etc. to make stuff, and you can make it fast and you can make a lot of iterations. There's a lot of emphasis on documenting. As Jessica is on a team that wants to document the whole process. We've done this by video, by blog, by every means that are possible. We're still trying to find a good way to document. It's very hard to redefine all the things that we've done, we make all the things that we've done, all the decisions we've made throughout the project. We try to put that in the documentation, but it's very hard. Okay, how did we do that? We started with one workshop to get a problem view. We explored the day. We explored what is good about the day, what's bad about the day, what they like, what they don't like. And in this phase, we noticed immediately they have a lot of ideas, but they don't know how to develop it. And I think a fab lab can assist in developing products. In the next phase, we thought, yeah, maybe they have these problems, but maybe they have underlying problems, what they have not seen, what is daily routine for them, but can be made better for them. But they just don't realize it because they're living with diabetes for like 20 years or something. So we observed them and we made three big pillars to work around because we needed to structure all these good thoughts of them, but we need to make something into motivation, public space, and personalization. The motivation was motivate to measure enough. Public space is using it with other people, like syringes and stuff. And personalization was making it their own so that they could use it better. Workshop in phase three was these three pillars. How can we develop something around that. How can we develop something for public space for all these things? And we've designed our own method. When we started prototyping like a month ago, and this is a fast sugar dispenser. Somebody has a lot of hypo, so the blood sugar drops very fast and they need to eat a lot of sugar, but it goes too slow. They cannot unravel the package, so we made something like a best dispenser that goes very fast. This is another example from self-management, is somebody with an insulin pump, and he has this wire running around him, like 1.20 meters. It's the standard length, and he wants something that wraps around there. It's just simple things that makes their life easier because it hooks on everything. And yeah, he wanted to carry something with him more easily because he's a sportsman. He wants to wear a full suit, and we develop a clip that clips onto his full suit so he can just carry everything around. So simple things like that we try to develop in our fab lab. Okay, what we think that fab labs can do is to redefine the process of making materials, of making self-management tools, because you can alter fast, you can personalize for everybody. And fab labs allow open source so everybody can make their own tool, can iterate, can redefine, redevelop, and make things better for themselves and for others, because they can share it with each other. All right, that's it. Thank you.